I'm here with Georgina from La Modiste Modeste, which means the modest milliner. Hi, Georgina.
Hi, Nessa.
So tell us all, are you the modest milliner?
Not at all, actually. I think wearing hats allows you to show off a little bit, allows you to get out of the ordinary in the everyday, and allows you to just dress up and go out and show off. It's also great if you're having a bad hair day. You can put one on and go out and hope nobody notices.
So how did you get into hat design then?
I'd always been interested in fashion all of my life, like most little girls I suppose, and my grandmothers are both seamstresses, so I'd always done dressmaking and soft furnishings, and then I went on an evening class at the London College of Fashion and had an absolutely inspirational tutor, and it just grew from there. I just became obsessed with it and it became my passion, and then it grew into my business.
Well, that's a lovely story. So how long have you been doing it now?
It's about 5 years now. I lose track really because I get so engrossed in it. I started off doing just making hats for friends and people I knew, and then it grew from there and became private commissions. I went into wholesale for a little while and selling by various boutiques around London and the South East. And now I've brought it back to being mainly private commissions because that's the bit that I really love. I don't like churning out the same thing over and over again.
Well, this one's called Evita.
Oh, makes sense.
Yeah, well, I think the colour works really well, especially with your makeup today. Mm-hmm. And it makes you look a bit like a 40s starlet.
I can't hear that enough. I really can't.
Absolutely.
So are each of your designs an individual design, or do you ever do two of the same one?
They're more or less individual. I'm sure there are certain themes that run through, and people can see that as your signature in your design. But I try to do something different every time, and it's actually quite hard to reproduce the same thing over and again if you're making things by hand. And I certainly prefer to do different things if I can. It's just more interesting that way.
Where would you find that you get your inspiration from?
That's actually a really difficult question to answer because I couldn't tell you where it comes from. Ideas just pop into my head. For one collection, it was all about mathematical symbols, which sounds really silly, but it just sparked off an idea. And most of the time it's about bold colours and strong contrasts and strong shapes. Those are the things I love.
So this is almost like a wedding hat for a sort of 1920s bride, isn't it?
That's right, yeah. I mean, this is called a cloche design, so it sits quite low on the head, but it's very cute. It's almost like a flower pot shape.
Yeah, it's beautiful. So most people think of hats, they think they wear them to a wedding and not really anywhere else. But do you find that you do much for other events as well?
Weddings are obviously the most popular side of what I do. And I think every woman who gets an invitation to a wedding has their first thought is, oh my goodness, where am I going to buy my hat? And how exciting, you know, you don't get a chance to wear one every day. But I also sell a lot to people who are going to the races. So in the summer, that's very popular. For people going to christenings, bar mitzvahs, all sorts of other events. And also more frequently now, it's for teenagers going to proms.
Oh, wow. I would never have thought that people going to proms would actually buy a proper hat. That's really nice to know, actually. That seems quite experimental.
Yeah, I think they are looking for something different. It might be a hairpiece. As the fascinators have become more popular, young girls are more likely to wear a headpiece rather than a hat, because it's easy to wear and it's just something fun, shows their individuality. This one is in a lot of my publicity photographs and it's one of the first styles that I made, actually. It took me weeks at the time because I was fairly inexperienced, and each piece has to be twisted and stitched and all of the beading is by hand. So it's actually quite elaborate, but it's proved quite a popular style. So I've done lots of variations on this theme.
Yeah. Well, it really frames the face, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Which is lovely.
Yeah, it's very flattering.
So last but definitely not least, you've got a gorgeous velvet one on my head now. It's beautiful. Tell me about this.
Well, I think it just goes to prove you've got a head for hats, Nessa, because they all suit you.
Well, I'm going to see if I can sneak out the door with this still on my head.
Okay.
But thank you so much for showing us all your hats. It's been such a pleasure.
And great to
Thanks,
meet you.
Thanks, Georgina.